I saw a broadcast by my friend and brother, the irrepressible Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, you know, commenting on my position on the Igbos in general, why I believe Nigeria can tap into the brilliance and the greatness of Igbo people instead of all this unhealthy rivalry between us all. And I wish to thank Mazi Nnamdi Kanu for his generous words for me, saying if he believed in Nigeria and he were to vote for someone as president, he would vote for me. I was deeply touched, honored, and humbled. But the truth is, I've decided after contesting in 2011 that I've played my part, and at 60, I should sit down, try to see work harder, enjoy a little, write books, read books, and then seek, find, and support good leaders in my dear country, Nigeria. That's all. What I'm doing has nothing to do with any presidential ambition. It's God who determines where anyone will be, where anybody will go. So I've left politics in terms of contesting, and all I'm doing now is to use the voice that God has given me to speak truth to power. We're not fighting anybody. I'm not a fighter. I'm not a rude person. I respect constitutional authority. I will continue to do so, to do my work professionally, ethically, and hope that we will find good leaders in the foreseeable future. No one is sure of what will happen. This evening, I'm not sure if you've heard another great news from the United States of America. It's incredible that while we're busy making cows, ethnicity, religion, money, political manipulations, our own priority at home, Nigerians abroad are doing well. And the good news is that the Nigerian-born Eno Titilayo Ebong is the latest appointee of President Joe Biden as acting director of U.S. Trade and Development Agency. So, you see, where you make merit and meritocracy your priority, everything will work well for you. America will not be America today if they are still engaged in frivolities like we do. Ethnicity, where you come from, who is your father, who is your mother, who cares? Can you deliver? So, I think she's probably the fourth appointee under this new government. This government is how old now? Maybe about 2-3 weeks. I don't think it's more than 2 weeks. The man already has his cabinet. The man has picked people from different parts of the world, and is not bothered about where you come from. That is the kind of president I would have been if I was allowed to govern Nigeria. I am very fortunate because, one, my grandparents were Muslims, my parents were Christians. My father was born in a village called Yere in Owan East local government of Edo State, and he migrated to Ilife. Lived, worked, died, and was buried in Ilife. So I do not carry all those prejudices that Nigerians carry all over the places. So I come from the two major religions. Nobody cares how you reach your God. That's your business. So in our family, we do not carry that baggage. When it comes to ethnicity, yes, Kwesi Samson. When it comes to ethnicity, I also do not carry the baggage, because to start with, I grew up, I was born in Ile Ife in 1960, had all my education in Ife, studied Yoruba for my first degree, and a master's in literature in English. So, I don't care where you come from, it doesn't bother me. Our staff at Ovation, nobody ever asked them where they came from. I contested for the highest office in Nigeria to be president of Nigeria in 2011. I never told any of my staff to vote for me. I never told them to join my party. Democracy should be a voluntary act. Fabulous. Well, I slept early. I just woke up. I just had my shower. And I just feel like interacting. I realize that sometimes I interact better in the night. Yes, so greatest effect. So for me, I don't care where you come from. So why should anybody now tell me an Igbo man cannot be president, an Igbo man cannot be chief of defense staff, chief of army staff, inspector general of police? I'm hearing now that the next inspector general of police will be a northerner, or they have even appointed him, I don't know, because I didn't follow much of news yesterday. So I should be the next Edo governor. That's impossible, and I'm not interested. That's the thing. How can the outgoing Inspector General of Police be a northerner, and then the incoming again will be a northerner? We complain about this. I have nothing against northerners, but every Nigerian should be given a sense of belonging. That's all. And people have complained about this. And you see, a leader must be sensitive to the yearnings of his people. Oh, super beauty, Regina Askia Williams. How are you, mama? How are you doing? I salute. You know? So, what do we do? We've cried and cried and cried, and that's why people are crying of marginalization. So when I speak about the Igbos, it's not because I want anything. It's not because I want to contest election. People think, oh, it's a political statement. You see, Nigeria is a country of conspiracy theorists. We all engage in it on a daily basis. If somebody dies of headache, they say somebody killed him, some witch must have killed him. If somebody is sick, they say, hey, some enemies of his father or mother after him. So it's the same thing when you speak politics. People say it's because you want something. If you criticize the Buhari, they say it's because he didn't make you minister. How many people can be minister? And those who want to be minister don't abuse government. Waleri 9000, Wale Adeyemo Omoba, over 70, how are you? So people just come and talk. The people must find a reason. Those who cannot do what you are doing. Sometimes some people will come, it's because they have not given you money. It's because anybody who knows me, you see where I sit down all the time. I'm sitting in my office, I'm working. While my mates are busy sleeping and snoring, I'm at work. A leader must be sensitive. It's true. And I told the president this in 2015. I said, I will continue to be your you know, special advisor, free of charge, from my house. If you are inside the seat of government, of course, you can't criticize your boss. So that's why I'm happy to be home. And whatever we need to feed ourselves, feed our family, we'll pray to God, work very hard, so that God will provide it. That's all. What are we looking for? We brought nothing to the world, which I take nothing. Anytime I go to a funeral, you won't believe it. I'm always staring, when we're in the church, I'm always staring at the coffin. I say, hey God, one day we're going to sleep inside this thing. God, God, so this is going to be our home. So that helps me to calm down. Calm down. What's all this gra-gra about? What's all this gra-gra about? Oh, someone is watching from Japan. How are you, Michael Chukuma? You know? So, for me, there is no way I'll be president. We won't tap into the brilliance of the Igbo people. It's not possible. It's a known fact. I've traveled all over the world, maybe over 60 countries and territories. And I've seen them in action. No human being is perfect. No human being is perfect, I must emphasize. But the talent of the Igbo, as I said, you can combine the Chinese, the Koreans, the Indians, and I will now add the Japanese to it. If we made the best use of those talents, today the Igbo man will not even care who is president. But when you try to make it look like they have committed eternal sin by fighting a civil war, which ended 51 years ago, where we said no victor, no vanquished, and we have not forgiven ourselves, then we're not serious. So, but my advice to my brothers and sisters is never mind. Keep doing what you know how to do best. You are among the best lawyers, the best doctors, the best surgeons, the best teachers, the best writers. My favorite writers growing up, of course, Chinua Achebe. We read a lot of Chinua Achebe in those days. We read a lot of Cyprian Ekwensi. I read John Munoye. You know, so I read Elechi Amadi. I read so many of them. Fantastic poets, fantastic writers. You know. So, hey, Uncle Whitecliff, Fawi Bear, Egbominie, he was my senior in secondary school. He's a big man in the United States of America. How are you, sir? He was one of those who inspired me growing up. Ah, such a neat man. You needed to see his uniform, school uniform, gator, everything, his shirt. No spanking clean. Safa Weebe. So that's it, you know. That's it. You have to live your life. Vietnam, wow, that's some journey. Igbo, so you see what I was saying? Our people are everywhere. And they are doing great things. This vaccine we are all shouting about right now, the vaccine, go and check. And the Igbo man is there. He's a major contributor to it. The Pfizer vaccine in the US. So, but let's us come home. The only time we see the greatness in Igbo people is when we're playing football. We don't mind because we know they will score. We don't care if where JJ Okocha comes from. We don't care where Kanuwanko comes from. You know, that's the only time. But let's talk about serious issues. No way. Imagine the whole of Africa if you don't have Igbo men as traders. That's why last year, when they shut down the Igbo shops in Ghana, they are still shut down. And I don't know why Nigeria cannot fight for them. And I reached out to everybody, including the foreign minister, who is an Igbo man. and said, you cannot abandon these people in Ghana. The little change I had, I sent to them. I was able to identify 111, got their account details and phone numbers, and I sent my token food money to them. They're all Igbos. Not one of them is a Yoruba man. It didn't bother me. I'm not aware if anybody, if any Igbo governor or anybody went to even assist them. You know? Yes, I can see my lips are dry, you know. I just woke up, so it's okay. We're not doing fashion parade there. This is a very serious matter. So, oh yeah, Philip Emeagwali is my friend. I hosted him in my house in London years back. We both received an award in London, so he came over to the house. Three of us, in fact, out of the three awardees, Philip Emeagwali, Igbo, Cosmos Madika, Igbo, Costaris. So I was the odd man out. Temitope Ayilara, how are you? So it doesn't matter, really.